Good morning. Good morning to our online viewers joining us from home this morning. Today is the third Sunday of Easter, and today's Mass is being offered for all the deceased members of the D'Amico family. We do ask you please take the time to silence all cell phones and devices, and please join us in our gathering song, hymn number 179, at the Lamb's High Feast, number 179. Please stand.
Of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Jesus appears to his disciples to renew their heart and strengthen their faith in the resurrection. We can sometimes feel like them and feel that he is far from us, but today we are reminded that he is with us, especially in the Eucharist. Let us seek the Lord and his grace on our journey as we prepare to meet the risen Christ in this Mass.
Lord Jesus, you are risen from the dead. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you free us from our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you promise us eternal life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, may your people exult forever in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the holy and righteous one and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did, but God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
When I call, answer me, O my just God. You who relieve me when I am in distress, have pity on me and hear my prayer.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
Know that the Lord does wonders for his faithful one. The Lord will hear me when I call upon him.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
O Lord, let the light of your countenance shine upon us. You put gladness into my heart.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
As soon as I lie down, I fall peacefully asleep. For you alone, O Lord, bring security to my dwelling.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is expiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, "I know him," but do not keep his commandments are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do your questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet. It is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you can see I have." And as he said this and showed them his hands and his feet, while they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. And he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures and said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are the witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to
you, Lord
Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah,
This morning in Luke's Gospel, we hear the resurrected Jesus as he appeared to the two disciples. To put it in context, this appearance is after the two disciples return from Emmaus and tell the other disciples they have seen the risen Lord. Like in last Sunday's Gospel, Jesus then greets the disciples with, "Peace be with you." The disciples are startled and terrified because they thought they might be seeing a ghost. And Jesus tells them to look at my hands and my feet, adding, "A ghost does not have flesh and bones." Jesus even takes it a step further and asks for something to eat to further prove his physical reality and that he really is the risen Christ. Jesus saying, "Peace be with you," is a special way of Christ revealing his divinity and the fulfillment of the law of Moses to his disciples and to us. According to the Compendium of Social Doctrine and Biblical Revelation, peace is much more than the absence of war. It represents the fullness of life, a gift that God offers to all people. Peace is the effect of the blessing God bestows upon his people, producing fruitfulness, well-being, prosperity, absence of fear, and profound joy. And that joy is what we are celebrating during the Easter season. Christ has risen from the dead. It's the same peace and joy celebrated when our Savior was born. The angel visited the shepherds, and like the disciples, the shepherds were afraid. But the angel told them, "Do not be afraid, for I bring you good news of great joy for all the people." And a little later, the angel continued with, "Glory to God in the highest, in heaven and on earth, and peace on earth to all those whom he favors rests." Our Lord and Savior wants us to be at peace, have joy, and believe in him. And we are believers as we celebrate the holy sacrifice of the Mass. Unfortunately, our faith journey is not always easy. And like the disciples, we experience times of doubt, uncertainty, and we may even be terrified, like the disciples. That's normal. It is what we do with that doubt that matters. Do we let it linger, let it fester and grow? Or do we try to find answers by reading scripture, doing research, talking to someone, and continually celebrating the sacraments? Remember, when Jesus returned, he showed love, patience, and mercy. Christ could have said, "I have been with you for 3 years, healed the sick, made the blind see, I fed 5,000, I fed 4,000, walked on water, turned water into wine. I even told you I'd rise in 3 days. And here I am, and you still have doubts." No, he does not say any of that, but he greets the disciples with "Peace be with you." Our Lord then explains his divinity to his disciples, saying, "Everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." He opened up the disciples' minds to the scriptures so they could understand. Christ tells them, "You are witnesses of these things." He wants them to go out and proclaim the risen Lord and spread the good news. Jesus wants to open our minds too. When we accept his peace and joy, we too can be witnesses to others and proclaim that our Lord has indeed risen. We are all disciples called to evangelize the life, death, and resurrection of Christ, to spread his divinity. On Easter, we celebrated the resurrection of Jesus, and we do see him in our lives. Take a moment to think about where and how we see the Lord in our lives. Sometimes you don't even realize it. I know I see Christ in my wife, in my children, and in my grandchildren. I see Christ here with us this morning. During this Easter season, may we celebrate and receive the peace and joy of our risen Lord and be strong disciples and witnesses of our Catholic faith.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and they look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Nourished by God's word, with confidence we now place our needs and the needs of the world before the Lord.
For the church throughout the world, that our hearts may be open to the presence of the risen Lord and be eager to share the peace that he gives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who exercise earthly power, that the Lord will inspire them to seek and uphold peace and justice in lands torn by war and violence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who make gifts to the Partners in Charity Appeal, that their generosity will give them joy and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish community, whether in times of joy or suffering, may we always recognize Jesus as real in our lives, especially when we are nourished by the Eucharist. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Judy Chapman, Ron Bruckman, Leo Padoni, Susan Brissett, Veronica Keating, Tara Wolf, Jennifer Dada, Mara Bennett, John Gow, Tom Duchon, John Lawrence Doyle, and all who are sick and suffering, may the presence of the risen Lord be revealed to them through the compassion of those who care for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all deceased members of the D'Amico family for whom this Mass is offered, and for Earl Sheldon and all our relatives, friends, and parishioners who have died, may they enjoy eternal peace and happiness before the throne of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those intentions we silently place before our loving God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Compassionate Father, hear the prayers we offer you in love and mercy, and keep us always united around your table through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
I saw during the preparation of the gifts that sin number 574, this day was made by the Lord, number 574.
This day was made by the Lord. Let us rejoice, let us be glad. This day was made by the Lord. Let us rejoice in salvation. I thank you, your love is eternal. You have given me life, you have given me life. I will proclaim wonders you do. This day was made by the Lord. Let us rejoice, let us be glad. This day was made by the Lord. Let us rejoice in salvation. Your right hand is up in triumph. You have given me life, you have given me life. I will proclaim the wonders you do. This day was made by the Lord. Let us rejoice, let us be glad. This day was made by the Lord. Let us rejoice in salvation. The stone which the builders rejected is a cornerstone, is a cornerstone. I will proclaim the wonders you do. This day was made by the Lord. Let us rejoice, let us be glad. This day was made by the Lord. salvation. You opened the gates of heaven. You have given me life. You have given me life. I will proclaim the wonders you do. This day was made by the Lord. Let us rejoice. Let us be glad. This day was made by the Lord. Let us rejoice in salvation. You are my strength and my Savior. You have given me life. You have given me life. I will proclaim the wonders you do. This day was made by the Lord. Let us rejoice. Let us be glad. This day was made by the Lord. Let us rejoice in salvation.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good of all his holy church.
O Lord, receive these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to praise you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death. By rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land and every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God. You love the human race and you always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples and now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and gave you thanks. Gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed unto us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis our Pope, Robert our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember all our brothers and sisters who have died, all who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with Saint Christopher, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you, through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, O God Almighty Father, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, so that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song is number 344, Gift of Finest Wheat, number 344.
Mystery of your presence, Lord. No.
Let us pray. O Lord, look with kindness upon your people and grant that those you are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Have a good week.
Our concluding song is hymn number 144, Glory in the Cross, singing the Easter verses, number 144.
Bow in homage.